Hi there, this is Ankit back again with another video. So first of all, welcome all of you in my channel KN Technology. So without wasting our time, let us start our today's session. So as usual, I was working on comment section. So I think I will complete the comment part of this project in this video. So follow me step by step. So in the last video, I have completed my PHP script for the same. So in this video I will try to show you the output of comment section, comment PHP script. So for this, come to Chrome browser using admin of Apache server. Bus book tutorial main.php. okay, click on bus ticket. Now here search for buses using the destination and boarding station and a specific date of journey. Okay, we will take 29. Now search bus. Okay, actually there is no bus available on the date chosen by me, so we will try to choose the bus only for Tuesday. So 3. No. Now as you can see, our two bus is available on Tuesday, that is Pamir Travels and Volvo Travels. Now clicking on permit travels details, you need to login first, because only after login I can access the seats available.php page. We need to perform search operation again for the second time. Okay, come to last part. So here you can see the comment section is visible, where you can write a comment in the form of text and submit it, and this comment will be visible in the comment section, which have a background color as green, as you can see on the screen. So let me check whether my comment is working or not after submitting the comment. So I'm writing comment, hi, this is Ankit from Pamir Travels. Okay, now click on submit. Okay, actually problem is that I have to create a separate table for comment section where I can save my comments submitted by the user, and for this I need to move to phpMyAdmin where I have online bus reservation database. So I need to first create a separate table for comment section, and I actually forgot to mention before. Okay, no any table for comment, so create a new table, and table name will be comments. Okay, first column will be user ID, second column will be comment ID, comment ID, and third column will be comments. Okay, comment ID will be also in, and comments will be worker. Length will be 100 for both the column, for all the three columns, and user IDs will be auto incremented. So we click on this checkbox and save this table. Okay, we will have comment table for the comments, and now again post the comment. Okay, let me check user ID from user. Okay, insert into comments. User ID and comments, values will be user ID and comments. Okay, user ID and comments, and table name is comments. Okay, now again type sub comments and submit, and click on submit comments. And let me check whether this comment is updated in our database or not. No updation is there, so there must be some error in our PHP script. Submit comments. Okay, let me check whether I have written the correct name of button. Submit comment. Control C and Control V. Okay, the name was incorrect. So change the name with submit comment. Now save it and again refresh the page. And write comment and post it. Okay, undefined. Actually, comments are inserted, but undefined index is ready. Why is it so? Okay. Now that's good. Okay, I need to delete that comment. So for this, yes, delete. Now again refresh the page. Okay, first let me save these lines. Okay, it is already saved. Now refresh the page. We have already refreshed the page. So again on clicking submit comments, yes, comment is inserted. Now we can see the comments here. Yes, this is good. And on refreshing the page, yes, it is also visible in our comment section, but name is not visible. The name should also be visible here. This is Ankit from, actually the name is not visible because we don't have updated any name in our database. Is it right? Yes, you can see there is no name updated for this user ID. AR89896. For this, we need to first update my name and phone number. Only after that, it can be visible in our website in the comment section. So, this part is correct. So we have completed the comment section. Okay. So, when I will work on account update. Okay, then after we will come to this part, and I will show you how to show the name of the author that has submitted their comments in the comment box. So we will do this later part. Now I think this is enough for this video, because I have completed my comment sections of our website. So in the next video I will work on the booking of seats. That is main part of our website. So thank you. See you in next video.